Noah, why did you decide to join the Navy?
Well, I was really bored. It was like February, and then we were quarantined. I was playing video games, and I was like, this is fucking stupid. This is freaking stupid. Sorry. I just felt like I was wasting my time. So I quit my job because I was working at Winco Foods. And then like a week later, I just Googled a recruiter's number and called him, and I was enlisted.
Was it like something you had thought about before that, or was it just out of the blue?
A lot of military personnel in my family, so it's always been something on the back of my mind that I know I could do.
But you never knew if it's what you wanted to do?
No. Still don't even know if I want it, if it's what I want. But it's happening, so it's cool.
That's so funny.
I can tell.
Wow, it's so exciting. Oh, big girl stretch.
So my sister was pregnant when I brought up the idea to my family. Like, yeah, I want to go into the military. I think it'd be fun. And I was just like, wait, I'm pregnant. I'm like, sorry, what's up? And now she's a month old and I'm leaving soon. Because it's like my own sister. It's really weird seeing her as a mother because she hasn't changed. It's not like she had birth. It's like, oh, I need to change my ways to have this kid. It's like, no, she's still a child, but just with a baby in her arms all the time.
What's up, loser?
Oh, bless you, bless you. Who's that? Oh, bless you, bless you.
How do you feel that you don't know how old your niece is gonna be when you come back? Like, how does that make you feel?
I mean, it's worth it. I mean, yeah, it sucks kinda. But it's worth it because I'm fighting for the country that I love. So, as cliche as that sounds. But yeah. Though I'm not sure what's about to happen next, I ask for strength from the Lord up above. Because I've been strong so far, but I can feel my grip loosening. Quick, do something before you lose it for good. Get it back and use it for good.
What's your workout routine like?
It's different. I mean, it's just mostly calisthenics. A lot of freaking push-ups, a lot of pull-ups, a lot of the sit-ups, and just like body weight squats, and a lot of running. A lot of running. Minimal checks. Turn on the TV, see a nigga Rolex, and fantasize about a life with no stress. I mean this shit sincerely. And as a nigga who was once in your shoes, living with nothing to lose, I hope one day you hear me. Always gonna be a bigger house somewhere, but nigga feel me. Long as the people in that motherfucker love you dearly. Always gonna be a whip that's better than the one you got. Always gonna be some clothes that's fresher than the ones you rock. Always gonna be a bitch that's better out there on the tours. But you ain't never gonna be happy till you love yours.
No such thing as a life that's better than yours.
Love yours.
No such thing as a life that's better than yours.
Love yours.
No such thing as a life that's better than yours.
I love yours.
No such thing, no such thing.
Is there anything you look back on throughout your life and you get sentimental about? Like, at times like this when you're moving on to something?
I mean, I guess like certain memories, just chilling with my homies, but I'm not gonna like cry about it or anything.
Yeah.
Because we're gonna make more memories later.
I know I think too much of what this life may bring. It keeps me up at night. 'Cause we're all moving on to bigger things. But it's not time to say goodbye. So out here tonight, let's throw a party if this is really over. Invite all your friends, even the ones that hate me.
I mean, it'll be difficult for everybody, but it'll get over it. It just takes time to get used to things. I think McKenna will cry the most. Katie won't cry. Katie won't cry at all. Shane won't cry. Sam will cry. Sam will cry. I'll miss like the dumb crap we do together, just like our friend group. That's it though. Because I need to change of pace. I'm sick of Damascus. I'm sick of Portland. I need to be somewhere else. That somewhere's in the middle of the ocean.
It's not time to say goodbye.
Sam Fitzgerald inspired me to journal. So I did, and then I was like, yeah, this is kind of fun, but it's like, it helps me get my thoughts out. But I kind of like want people to just like see it, but not like shove it in their faces. So I was like, yeah, why don't I just blog and just see if people happen to come across it. So that's what it kind of started with, was just me journaling, but on the internet and posting it for everybody to see. My senior year of high school is when, like, around that time when I picked up a camera. I was like, yeah, this is kind of fun, you know, like just messing with it, yeah, capturing just still images. But I took my graduation money and then bought like an actual camera. I would go downtown Portland and take like super just like edgy, really like dark photos. And I thought it was cool.
Happy birthday, bud.
Okay, I was debating between Navy and Army. But what made me decide the Navy is because my great-grandfather fought in World War II in the Navy. It's like, well, that's good. What better way to honor his legacy than just doing the same thing he did? I mean, like, I ain't scared of death, which just sounds super dark, but it's not. I ain't scared to die. So, like, why not take that mindset and, like, do something with it instead of sit at home and have a basic, boring 9-to-5 job and just, I don't know, it just sounds lame.
Do you think you're gonna come out of the other side a different person?
For sure, in some ways. In other ways, I'll be the same person I was then.
So, you gonna have kids, Noah?
I'm gonna have a lot of kids.
How many kids?
I mean, at least 3, max 8. So, anywhere in between there.
Oh, that's gross.
Hey, come on. Date okay.
Not having kids.
Started with it. It's not hot enough in the kitchen. They saying it's it. I guess I'm the one thinking different. I'm slick.